really proud of our group. We obviously were very ready to play. We were down 8 early, and their big guys were giving us some trouble, and I thought we stayed poised and finished the half with good momentum. Second half, I thought we did it on both ends. We defended well, did a better job on their bigs, and then I think, you know, you saw what we can do offensively when we get out and run and share the ball. We're really, really explosive. I can't say enough about these two guys right here. First of all, my baseball player, you know, he's a pretty good basketball player too, don't you think? I mean, to go 19-14, what a man. And then I thought Demetrius, you know, just really ignited us with his ball pressure, and probably his dunk was kind of the exclamation point to kind of say, we're probably going to win it today. So, we're playing well, and you just kind of want to bottle it.
Mike, you've had some explosive offensive teams, but did you even cut yourself there in that run in the second half?
Yeah.
Like, you guys can really do it.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we've had some explosive offensive teams, but we do it even more powerfully. This team does it even more powerfully. And I'm really proud of our bigs. It was going to be a night where you were going to foul and you had to be unselfish and give your body up. I thought Zach August handled that great, you know, and then Martin comes in and leans on him, and then Torres comes in and leans on their bigs. Those guys really did a great job for us and gave themselves up physically against two really physical big guys.
Mike, you started that run with like 4 dunks in a row. Is that product of your defense? Is that, where does that kind of spurt come from?
Well, there's no question that our ball pressure and us getting in passing lanes is something we can do. You know, Demetrius spearheads that, and when he's pressuring the ball, all of a sudden those entry passes are longer, and now Jaron can jump through a passing lane, and Steve and Pat. But I mean, Demetrius tonight, he got his hands on stuff, you know, on the entry pass. He was deflecting the entry pass. And it's demoralizing when you have to play against that. It kind of wears you out. I thought Demetrius made just great choices on offense tonight too. Just, you know, when to take a shot, when to involve people. And what I'm seeing, what's great, is he's talking more each week. He's really a leader for us now. He's really got command of our system and is a strong voice for us.
In addition to that, what else have you seen in terms of Demetrius's development? What else is he doing more now than he was?
Well, I think he's become a better guard. You know, his basketball decisions with the ball are that of a college guard now. That's where he made a big jump. You know, he talked about, I want to be better with his decision. He wanted to be less turnovers than last year. And he's playing with supreme confidence. Him and Jaron are playing off of each other beautifully. They both can handle it. They both can play off the ball. I know he was really ready to play in this one. I mean, just watching him yesterday, he was excited about playing down here. I think all the Indiana kids always love playing in this event. And we love this event because we've won 3 in a row, so let's keep playing every year. We love it.
How does Austin give up 5 inches and 7 inches and still battle and compete and come out on top?
He is one physical guy, and he's got a great base. And then he bounces up there and bothers a shot. I mean, he's hard to play against because of his strength. And he at least had Hawes pushed off enough where it was a trickier shot. And then he was up there bothering some of those shots with his athletic ability. But again, his role is very important for us. You saw it again tonight. I mean, when we made the run in the first half, he was in there. He was in there, kind of got a ball screen roll. He goes 3 for 4 from the foul line during that spurt. And he was not a guy we could rely on making free throws much last year. So he's, you know, that's something that he's improved in.
Questions for Demetrius and Pat?
Demetrius walked through the dunk. Was there any question that you were finishing like that?
I just wanted to finish strong, have a play to kind of set the tone, just ignite our team. So that's just what I wanted to do.
Hey, Pat, you want to walk through your dunk too?
It was all Demetrius. He passed it to me. I just had to go up and finish. I mean, I think one thing that you can say about our team is the unselfishness. I mean, we get those plays just because of our ball movement, because our chemistry playing together, and then it gets open shots, and we just got to finish strong where it's our time to be open.
Pat, it was like a 6-8-point game with like 13 minutes to go, and then it was almost like you guys were shot out of a cannon or something. In that sequence, I mean, it's hard to run through every play, but what happened there to let you spread a game that was 6 or 8 points to 31? Could you talk about what happened?
We got our offense flowing. I think, obviously based off statistics and based off just watching us play, our offense is something that can really ignite us. But what no one really knows is the igniting of it is from the defensive end. So as long as we can stick with the defense, and you know, the offense wasn't flowing as much as we wanted in the first half, wasn't flowing as much in the beginning of the second half, but we stuck with it defensively. And you know, if we can stick with that and really, you know, rely on our defense, then that offense is going to come. It's just a matter of when.
Demetrius, where do you feel you've advanced the most in your game?
Just making decisions with the ball, trying to be better with it, getting the ball to guys in certain spots. I feel like I've really grown in that area. And then just being confident in myself and my abilities, just trying to go make plays for my teammates.
Pat, how do you approach a night like tonight where it's going to be rugged down low and you're kind of carrying a lot of the rebounding responsibilities there too?
It's just a matter of being tough. I mean, I know my teammates have my back, and I know I have theirs. So it's a matter of, you know, doing the tough little things that we've worked on all offseason, that we've worked on all, you know, the beginning, you know, 12, 13 games, whatever it may be. And it's a matter of having them translate and carry over and, you know, keep making those hard-nosed plays that, you know, we, you know, came up short on a few times last year.
Can you talk about what kind of a matchup problem Demetrius gives opponents?
Yeah, you got to look at his physical build, obviously, and then you just got to look at his toughness and his you know, mental capacity to just take on whoever's in front of him. I mean, he's out here to make a statement, just like our team in general, and he's the lead guy on the defensive end and with the ball on the offensive end. So it's just a matter of where he looks at a guy, you know, head to head when he steps on the floor, and no matter who it is, he thinks he can beat him, and we think he can beat him night in and night out.
What do you think about when there's a 7'2" guy between you and the basket?
That I, you know, better put up higher, finish or jump higher, something like that. I think that's one thing I struggled with last year is finishing at the rim. And so just trying to make better decisions. Like there was a couple times I dropped it off to a guy for a dunk, or you know, a couple times I put it up high and finish. So just trying to make better decisions in that area.
Pat, this was a 4-point game, went from a 4-point game to a 30-point game. How much of that was you guys, like Coach said last week, just being cruel and just going for it there?
Yeah, I mean, it was a matter of us coming together and relying on our defense. Like I said before, if we can rely on our defense like we have been throughout this season, then the offense is going to come. We're a very good offensive team, but the defense is where it all starts for us, and that's the thing that we pride ourselves on, and that's the thing that you know, we can still improve on moving forward. So we just got to come in day in and day out, know we have room for improvement, and keep on each other's backs to make sure we do improve.
Any questions?
Merry Christmas.